Hi everybody, it's Dr. Karen, and today we are going to be talking about the lit review. So I have recently been talking to a lot of different graduate students and really just talking to people who are stuck at various stages of the dissertation. And one of the most common areas of struggle is actually writing the lit review. So there are a couple different reasons why people get stuck at this lit review chapter. So number one, because often it is the first chapter you write. If you do use the five chapter dissertation format, the one that's really the most common, or in a lot of the other formats are really spin-offs of that one, what usually you end up doing is that you write your lit review first, which ends up being your chapter two, and then you might either do your methods or your chapter one next. And then after you've done those first three chapters, obviously you propose, you get your IRB approved, you collect your data, and then you write up your results and your discussion. So within those first three chapters, the lit review ends up being the most difficult for a lot of people because a lot, that is usually the first thing that you write after you do your prospectus. And because it's the first, you're kind of getting the juices flowing and building that momentum and really just getting in the habit of learning that dissertation level writing. So because of that, it can be really difficult to build that momentum. If you, you know, there's a lot of examples in the past. Like I know one of my former college instructors used to use the example of J.K. Rowling, who wrote the Harry Potter books. If you look at the different, all of the different books in that series, you notice that they get longer and longer as she goes on. Obviously, I know it's totally different type of writing, but it's writing nonetheless. So if you look at Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone or Philosopher's Stone, depending on if you're in the UK or the US, that book wasn't that long. And she actually wrote that book, I think, on a napkin in a cafe or something like that. But as she went on and the story developed, she was able to crank out more writing, and she was able to actually write those later books, which were way longer, way meatier, in a shorter amount of time than she wrote the first one. And the reason that happens, and that happens to a lot of writers, is just because of momentum and building that habit. So that's the first thing, is that it's when you haven't done that level of writing before, even if you've been in coursework with little mini deadlines, it can be really hard to get started. So that's one reason why it is difficult to write that lit review. And then the other reason is that it does tend to be the meatiest, most difficult chapter. And the reason that it is the most difficult is because it requires the skill of synthesis. So basically what that means is that, you know, a lot of times, and, you know, fiction writers don't necessarily have to deal with this as much, but when you're just writing, like you're telling a story about what happened, you have that story in your head and you just put it on paper. Obviously, there's more to it than that. You need an outline and a sequence and a flow and characters and things like that. But what you're doing when you are writing your lit review is that you're taking other people's work and you're synthesizing it into your own work. And so that can be way more difficult than, say, your results section, when you're literally just listing out the data and explaining what the data say, or your discussion section where you're just saying, well, this is what the numbers say, this is what they mean, and these are the conclusions that we can draw. So yes, you're pulling some information together, but not to the extent that you're doing when you're writing the lit review. And so the thing about that is that it requires, the lit review chapter requires the most compiling of information and the most research, because what you have to do is that you have to be able to not just write, but you have to be able to read and then put that into writing. So the reason that a lot of people get stuck is number one, because of momentum, but number two, because they don't have that skill of synthesis and they don't have a good process. So what I'm going to share with you today is just a brief overview of how you'd actually go through this and just some ways you can tell or really just some mindset shifts that you can have when it comes to writing your lit review that might help to start move you forward. So one of the biggest ones that I wanted to share is that a lot of times people will get stuck, and I will talk to people and I will say, okay, how much progress have you made on your writing and in the last couple months? And they will say, well, I haven't done any writing because I'm still reading. And so I'll say, you know, how often do you work on your dissertation every week? And they'll say, you know, 3 to 4 times a week or however much. Maybe it's just once a week. Maybe it's every day that they're sitting there for hours and hours searching through articles. And what I found is that a lot of times people will be at that stage way longer than they think they should. So yes, you don't want to start writing your lit review when you only have 2 or 3 articles and you haven't done a thorough review of the literature out there, and you don't at least have the themes and the flow somewhat in your head. But where people often get stuck is that they stay in that stage for way too long, and they get into a rabbit hole of reading articles and feeling like they've never saturated the literature, and then they never get out of that stage. And so as a result, they haven't even started writing yet, and they're really just getting stuck there. So really the process that you can use is that, yes, obviously at the beginning, you do want to collect more articles and get as much as you can. But what you want to start doing throughout that process, when you are starting to, let's say, dump articles into different file folders on your computer, is start taking note of those different themes. And so as you're doing that, you might have different file folders with different themes and different topics, and you're starting to sort that out. And once you get to the point where you've got, you know, 20 to 30 articles, obviously you want to be talking to your chair throughout this process. But once you get to that point that you've got that many articles, you can start to create a loose outline as far as what you think that your draft is going to be. So how that might look for you is that you might be starting to skim through the abstracts of those articles and thinking, okay, and you start separating them into piles. Maybe they're not physical piles if you're doing this electronically, but maybe post-it notes with a brief note about what was covered in that article, and maybe you've got these post-it notes arranged. And so when you have all of those articles that you're starting to gather and you have an idea of just the topics of all of them, then you're going to start organizing that into themes. And what will happen is that as you start looking at those themes and start just fleshing out that outline, not necessarily writing it right away, but just fleshing out what the outline is going to be, what's going to happen is that you're going to have an idea of how this is starting to flow. And what that is going to do is going to trigger some more ideas about other articles that you need to get, or maybe themes or patterns where you might need more research. So all that's going to do is funnel you down. So usually what you do is you start out very, very broad with your lit review. And so the first couple articles that you're going to talk about are really broad. And then you're gradually funneling that down to get more and more specific as you get down to that research question. So that's why when you start getting a decent pile of articles, maybe 20 or 30, you can start thinking about that funnel, how you're funneling down to that question, and start sketching out that outline. It does not mean that you're going to stop there as far as those articles go, but you do want to start fleshing it out. And then what you're going to do from there is that you're going to start adding to those articles. And as you get some more, once you start to add to those, then you actually get to the point where you can start doing some outlining and doing some legit writing. So the thing is that a lot of times people don't start with that outlining process and at least start with maybe reading some articles and start inserting them into that outline. They actually wait too long before they do that. And then what happens is that they get stuck and they have no idea. Then they have this list of 100 articles and they have no idea what to do with them. But if you're doing that in tandem, then what happens is that you're starting to flesh out that article, or not the article, that chapter of your dissertation. So that lit review, you're starting to kind of see it play out. So what happens is that you might get to a point where you're like, okay, you know what? I've got a decent amount of articles. Maybe you've been, as you're going through them and gathering them, maybe you've been starting to organize those themes. You get to that point where you're going to start writing. And what people don't realize is that when you actually start writing, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're done with gathering articles, and that's okay. Because once you get to that point where you've got, and you know, it depends on the university. Sometimes they want you to have like 50. So let's say that you've got your, you know, you've kind of been going back and forth between your outline and your articles, and you know, you're fleshing out your themes, and maybe you've been doing that for a while, and you're up to, you know, 40, 50 articles, more if your department requires you to have more. Once you get to that point, that's going to be where you're actually going to really start writing your lit review for real. So you've been kind of loosely making that outline up until this point, but then here is where you're going to actually start reading the articles and taking more detailed notes and start organizing all those little summaries into your lit review as they fit into those themes that you've been outlining. And what that's going to do for you is going to help you to figure out where you might need to add articles. So it's really that misconception that you need to be done and that you have to have every article in the world on your topic before you can start writing. And that's where a lot of times I see people getting stuck. So as we wrap this up today, again, really the main thing for you to take away from this is, number one, it's hard because you need to build momentum. Number two, it's hard because you are synthesizing other people's work and making it your own. And then number three, it's also hard because a lot of us feel like we can't start writing or outlining anything until we have enough articles. So I would encourage you to, if you are in those initial stages and you've got a decent amount of articles, at least start trying to flesh out that outline, because that's going to help you work through this and figure out where you need to add articles and when you are actually done. So those are those three things for you to take away from this today. So what I'm going to do with you, or for you right now, I know a lot of times in my lives I do give you a link to sign up for a session for me, but today I'm actually going to ask you something different. So today, what I would like to ask you is just share in the comments, number one, if this resonates with you. Are you getting stuck on your lit review, and does this sound familiar? And number two, if it doesn't, if you're stuck somewhere else, just leave a comment below and let me know where you're stuck and what's going on, so I can get a better understanding of how to best support everybody in here. So with that, again, leave a comment, let me know where you're struggling, and we'll wrap this up for today. So everybody, thanks for listening.